Hey, what's good, everybody? It's your boy Nick Bossin, and right now you're Bossin with Boss.
You don't want these problems? Come and play with a boss. You say you really with it. We don't take no loss. Cause I be bossin. I be bossin. Cause I be bossin. I be bossin.
What's good, everybody? It's your boy Nick Bossin, the creator of Bossin Inc. And this is actually my very, very first webisode. I have a lot of people that have been reaching out to me and asking me a lot of information on how to start a clothing brand. A little bit about me, I've been doing this for about 2 years now. I'm a photographer, I'm also a filmmaker, a creative as in general. All my information is on the screen right now if you want to follow me. Also, make sure you hit that subscribe button to check out some of my other videos. I have a lot of music videos, short films, commercials, and hopefully I'll be doing a lot more of these videos if I get some good feedback. Let's get into today's topic, which is 5 tips that I feel will help you start a clothing brand. Number one, start with what you have. Okay, now there's a really, really common misperception out there that you have to have a ton of money into going into a clothing brand. I'm not gonna say, you know, that this didn't cost me a lot of money, because it has cost me a lot of money, but a brand is something that's long-term anyway, so you can start basically now by just doing some research. Research is free. You don't have to wait until you get all the money. Something about the law of attraction, when you start taking the first steps, everything else starts to kind of align. I'm kind of big on that, you know, the whole secret. If you have a design and you have enough money to print one shirt, start wearing it around. And once you take that first step, the dots will start to connect. Number two, win the local crowd. So, wherever your hometown is, whatever city you're from, you gotta get them to follow you. You gotta be the hometown hero. You gotta get the people in your city to embrace what you're doing. What that's going to do for you is gonna have a major effect on how other people respond to your brand. Start with your family members. Start with the people that you know are gonna support you. See if they'll wear a shirt for you. See if they'll buy a shirt. Start frequenting the popular places in your city. Start getting connected with some of the popular musicians. You may have some good artists out in your city who may be willing to support you. You'd be surprised. A lot of people, when it comes to like local, like home pride type of situations, a lot of people are willing to support. The thing is, you just gotta ask. You never know. Number three, and I can't really stress this enough. Create content. You gotta create content. You have to, I really don't think there's a such thing as creating too much content. Since I'm a photographer and a video person, it's easier for me, but there's really no excuses, because the way we have cell phones, you can create content, you can make videos, whether you're on Snapchat, whether you're on Instagram, whether you're on Facebook, make sure you are creating content. Document your journey. The shift has gone from television to our phones. So what is everyone doing right now? They're scrolling down their feeds, they're on Snapchat, they go to Instagram, they go back from Instagram to Twitter to Facebook, and they're looking for content. You have to think about your social media account as a TV station. So if you're HBO, if you're ESPN, if you're TNT, if you're TBS, what happens when there's nothing on your channel? People are gonna flip to the next channel. You need to overload them with content. If you're not creating 10, 20 pieces of content a day, at least minimal, just spreading it across different platforms, you're not doing enough. Stay in people's face, because that's where your brand is gonna get recognized. It's all about attention. If you can bring attention to your brand, then you'll have major success. Have patience. That's number four. You have to have patience in this game. Nothing's gonna happen overnight. Me, myself personally, this is a long-term journey. I honestly want my brand to exist like after I'm dead. You know, think about the companies that have been around for 50, 60, 70, 100 years. Like, you know, brand household names and things like that. They weren't just things that happened within a year. Dame Dash herself said that it's gonna take at least 5 years for you to establish a reputable brand. You have to have like a 10-year plan, a 20-year plan. This has to be something that you plan on doing. Me, myself, this is, like I said, this is a lifetime journey for me. Think about when you plant a tree. Think about how long it takes for a tree to actually bear fruit. That's how I want you to think about your clothing brand. Don't rush things. Make sure that you're taking your time. The tortoise won the race. Five, live your brand. You have to live your brand. If you're not living your brand, then no one's ever gonna follow you. A brand is more than just a t-shirt with just a print on there. So, let's just say your brand is about health and fitness. That means you need to be living that type of lifestyle, that you need to be focused on healthier living, going to the gym, eating better. Otherwise, your brand will be looked at as a joke. And remember, it's not what you do when people are watching, it's what you do when people aren't watching, when you aren't logged into social media, what you're doing. A brand is a lifestyle. So there you have it. Those are my five tips right there to starting a clothing brand. Hopefully you guys enjoy what I had to say. Again, hit the subscribe button and make sure that you check out some of my other videos. Follow my Instagram, and hopefully I'll be doing more of these videos. Give me a feedback in the comments. Let me know what you guys think, all right? Thanks.
Cause I be bossing. I be bossing. Cause I be bossing. I be bossing.